So talk to me about the inspiration and also the intention of writing your book, Movement for Self-Healing, an essential resource for anyone seeking wellness.
You know, I want to tell you something pretty funny. I had an immigration problem, and my lawyer thought I'm going to lose, okay, because I applied for a category that closed, and it related to my work. And I contacted a spiritual teacher. One of my clients knew him. So I contacted him, and he meditated for me. And it's interesting. The day that I met the immigration cop, my lawyer was so afraid. And I wasn't. And that guy, when we finished, said, I mean, those people normally are mean, right? When we finished, he said, I have no right to tell you, but I'm all for you. And my case was resolved. It took some time. It was all kinds of procedure, but it was resolved. And that guy, I met him, but he was not a good student of mine. He did not do his exercises. But he said, you have no choice but to write a book. And that's what started me to want to write a book. And then I wrote about my life experience, because I'm very happy about it, because I don't have enough of a formal education. And yet, these days, many physicians study with me. Right. And yoga practitioners study with me, and physiotherapy study with me. And many, many people study with me in many different parts of the world because of the contents of my teaching. Right. And that book, in many ways, was like my business card in some ways. Mm-hmm. But I didn't do it as a business card. I was really bringing up the cases that I had. And it was just wonderful to bring them. You know, like when I bring the case of the man with multiple sclerosis who was desperate, who was dizzy, who felt so bad. And one day, and don't ask me how I knew it, I take him to the balcony and get him to move his head in rotating motion. And he's dizzy already, right? He moves it a couple of times, he throws up. He becomes completely green. And even with my poor vision, I could see how he became green. He had no strength to stand. Take him to the table, massage him, take him again. He moves his head in rotating motion, throws up. After the eighth time, he didn't throw up, he just felt weak. And ever since then, he was not dizzy. How the hell did I know that? I don't know, you know? So the idea was, I guess, to actually get him to do exactly what he's suffering from in order to recover from it, just like they're doing homeopathy. But I did not know anything about homeopathy then, and I just did it, you know? So cases like this, you know, I really feel that with intensive work, when you can contemplate the needs of your clients, you can make a change in the body.